program to shuffle deck of cards. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain. In this video, we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to shuffle a deck of cards. So guys, cards are something that we might have played since our childhood, or we might have not played, we might have seen them. So everyone, in their life have seen the cards. In the cards, we have four different kinds of cards. We have spade, we have club, we have hearts, and we have diamonds. Now today, what we need to write a program that will allow us to shuffle the cards. And so if you have ever played cards, or even if you have not played, so I'll tell you that when we play cards, we give five cards to the next person. So what we'll be doing, we'll be creating a range of five cards from that deck of cards as well. To create this program, we will be using two modules. We'll be using the random module and we'll be using the editor tools. With the help of these two modules, we'll be creating this program. Let's have a look on how it can be done. As I said, we will be using two modules over here. First of all, let's import them. So I'll be importing random, comma, iter tools, and we'll be using both of these modules. So after getting these tools, we need the 52 cards. So after getting these two modules, we'll be needing our cards over here. For the cards, we'll be creating a variable called as deck. Inside this deck, so this deck will contain a list of all the cards, and inside the list we'll be having the tuple values. First of all, we'll be using iter tools to iterate. So iter tools dot product to iterate in a range of 1 to 14, because we have 13 cards over here. So we'll be having a range of 1, 14, and this range will be multiplied by spade, club, hearts and diamond. So I'll be writing spade, comma, club, comma, hearts and diamond. Now this will give us a product of range of 1 to 14, and 1 to 14, what will happen? These 1 to 14 will be multiplied with spade, then club, then heart, then diamond. That means we will get output in this way: 1 time spade, 1 time club, 1 time heart, 1 time diamond. Then next number is 2. So 2 times spade, 2 times club, 2 times heart, times of 2 of diamond. 3, then 3 of spade, 3 of club, 3 of heart, 3 of diamond. This is how we will be getting all the outputs over here. Now, we need to put it inside a list. That's why we'll be creating a list over here. So, I'll be writing a list. And inside the list, we'll be getting each element as a tuple. So, as soon as I print this deck, let's have a look on what do we get in our output. So, let me just run it. So, in the output, we have over here 1 of spade, 1 club, 1 heart, 1 diamond, 2 spade, 2 club, 2 heart, 2 diamond, 3 spade, 3 club, 3 heart, 3 diamond. In this way, we have got it up to 14, and because it is a range, so 14 will not get counted over here, because we have only 13 cards inside our deck. So, we'll be getting the last number as 13 of spade, 13 club, 13 heart and 13 diamond. So, in this way, we will get the output. Now, what do we need to do? We need to shuffle this card, because this is how we play cards, that we shuffle all of them. So to shuffle them, we'll be creating a variable called as. So to shuffle all of them, we need to write random dot shuffle, and we'll be shuffling the deck. Let's print it. So I'll just remove it from here. So previously the deck was coming well arranged. Now let's see after shuffling what does happen. If I run it, I'll get the output in this way, that we have 7 spade, 10 spade, 3 hearts, 11 spade, 8 hearts, 6 diamond, 8 spade, 7 club. So we are getting a different output. That means these cards have been shuffled. Now from these shuffled cards, we need to pass the 5 cards to a person who is playing with us. To pass the 5 cards, we'll be creating a for loop over here, that for I in range. And because we have to pass 5 cards over here, we'll be writing 5. Now what we will be printing over here, that we need to print it in this way, that if I'm giving cards to a person, it should say 7 of spade. Now 7 inside this tuple and spade over here. So 7 inside this tuple is 0 index, and spade over here is index number 1. So how I'll be printing it, that print deck, inside the deck, we're talking about the list of deck. Inside the deck, we'll be going in the 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. Like 5 range will be there. So first of all, we'll be going in 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 5 range will be there. And here we'll be writing I. So our range is 1 to 5. That's why we'll be writing I. And inside the I for the first card, we'll be writing 0. Because if I take the example over here, that if I have a deck in this way, that I have 7, comma, spade. And let's say it's a list of 2 elements, that 8 of hearts. So it's a list of 2 elements which has 2 tuples over here. So inside the list, the range is I, that is, this is on number 1 and this is on number 2. That means, this is on number 0 and this is on number 1. Okay. And inside this also, we have a tuple. So tuple also has indexing. The number 7 is on number 0 and spade over here is on number 1. So this thing only we are going to write that dec of I, that means 7, comma, of, comma. For writing the spade, again, we will take the list name, that is dec. From the dec, we will go to the I index only, that means the same index. And inside the same index, inside the same tuple, will fetch the index number 1 over here. Now let's run and see what output we will get. So as soon as I run, it will give me 8 of hearts, 6 of diamonds, 10 of diamonds, 10 of hearts, and lastly 8 of diamonds. So 5 cards has been distributed in this way. So I hope guys this is clear, that how we have randomly shuffled the cards plus how we have given 5 cards to the next person over here. All we need to do is use the iter tools and random module. Inside the iter tools, we have iter tools dot product, which allow us to multiply a range with the list we have given over here, and gives us an output in the format of a list because we have put a list over here. After that, we have used a random module, that random dot shuffle deck. That means we need to shuffle this deck. We have printed the deck as well, and from this deck only we have given the 5 cards to the person who is playing with us. So I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions, and for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.